Think restoring sight to the blind is only a Bible story? Think again. Hey there, science fans. Dr. Kiki from This Week in Science, here for D News. The brain is a wild and crazy place. For years, scientists have thought that there are periods of time during childhood called critical periods when we have to have certain kinds of experience in order for our senses to develop properly. For our visual sense, studies suggest that the critical period for correcting any kind of deficiency lasts from birth until about 2 years old. After 2 years old, visual problems like amblyopia or lazy eye, for instance, can still be reversed, but the success rate decreases the older you get. And there seems to be a big difference when treatments are attempted after around age 6. The idea of critical periods in vision was first tested by David Hubel and Torsten Weisel in the 1960s by sewing kittens' eyes shut and measuring brain activity in the visual cortex. Totally gruesome, I know. They found that the neural pathways connected to the closed eye were withered in comparison to the normal eye, and that they never developed vision in that eye, even after the eye was reopened months later. Because adult cats can have fully developed visual systems, sight could be restored even after a year of having an eye sewed shut. Hubel and Weisel won a Nobel Prize for this work. The concept of critical periods has to do with the idea that cells that fire together wire together. And if your brain doesn't get that early experience of visual stimulation, the neural pathways for vision just won't have a reason to link up and create the system for vision. It just won't happen. In fact, it's been shown that the visual cortex itself begins to respond to other sensory input, like sound and touch. You might have heard of blind people who use a form of echolocation, like bats, that involves using clicks and echoes to get around, even while riding a bike. Brain imaging shows that the brains of these people are organized so that they see the landscape based on what they hear. Knowing that the brain reorganizes in this way, with other senses taking up the real estate for vision, can that process be reversed, or is it really permanent? An exciting study published in the Journal of Neurophysiology this week by a research team from the Université de Montréal and the University of Trento suggests that it can. Kind of. The team imaged the brain of a 50-year-old woman, both before and after she underwent surgery to implant an artificial cornea called the Boston keratoprosthesis in her right eye. The woman had extremely low levels of vision for her entire life, since birth, and compared to people with normal sight and those who lost their sight later in life, like during adulthood, she had both structural and functional reorganization of the visual cortex. Before the surgery, the visual area responded to auditory input. However, after the surgery, there was a significant reduction in the auditory response. But it wasn't total, even after 7 months. So, this study and others along these lines suggest that some of the brain shaping that takes place during the critical periods of development is permanent, but some of it can be reversed. The trick now will be discovering what makes the difference. Do you want to help sight restoration research happen? You can, by donating to Fight for Sight, an organization that supports and inspires research in vision and related sciences by granting funds to scientists early in their careers. What do you think of research like this? Does it give you hope? Tell us in the comments below, or you can find me on Twitter @DrKiki. And be sure to subscribe to D News for more science every day.